Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the next portion of biology, that is vitamins. What is a vitamin? A vitamin is a organic molecule. Vitamin is an organic molecule. What do you mean by organic? Organic means we are getting it naturally. Or we can say we are getting it from the nature. Vitamins are mostly present in the fresh fruits, and vegetables. As we know that these vitamins are also comes under nutrients. On the basis of quantity of nutrients, we can classify the nutrients mainly into two, that is micronutrients and macronutrients. And micronutrients means the quantity needed is very small. That means smaller quantity needed, but its function is greater. Good to all of you. Micronutrients means the quantity needed is smaller and its function is greater. Micronutrients examples are minerals and vitamins. Examples, minerals and vitamins. Macronutrients, it needed larger quantity, but its function is lesser in the body. Example, carbohydrates. Got it all of you? Yes. And next, on the basis of solubility, we can classify the vitamins again into two. On the basis of solubility, vitamins can be classified into two. First one is fat soluble. And second one is water soluble. Do you know how many types of vitamins are there? There are total 13 vitamins are there. What are they? That is A, B, C, D, E and K. I said 13, but when you check, you can see here only 6 are there. But this B, vitamin B consists of, vitamin B complexes you may heard about. When mouth ulcer comes, the doctors used to suggest you to have a B complex tablets. So here B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B9 and B12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, total how many are here? 8 vitamins are there. Here, except B, you can count it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, total 30 vitamins are there. Now, we can check out what are the fat-soluble vitamins. Fat-soluble vitamins are vitamin A, D, E, and K. Water soluble vitamins are vitamin C and B. Sometimes mother used to tell you that should not wash the vegetables after cutting. So the reason behind is there is a chance for the loss of nutrients from those vegetables. Understood? Vitamins total how many are there? 13 are there. And on the basis of solubility, we can classify that into two. That first one is fat soluble and second one is water soluble. And fat soluble vitamins are A, D, E and K. Water soluble vitamins are vitamin C and B. Next we are going to discuss is dietary fibers. Dietary fibers, or it is called roughage. And these dietary fibers are not having any nutritive value, but it is very essential for the removal of waste materials from our body. Removal of waste materials are happening with the help of dietary fibers. And another important component which is essential for body is water. Water is also helping for the elimination of waste materials like urine, sweat, etc. Water also helping us to eliminate the waste materials from our body. Our next term we are going to discuss is balanced diet. What do you mean by balanced diet? The diet which contains all the nutrients in a proper proportion. Okay. All the nutrients in a proper proportion. Proportion is called a balanced diet. Is called a balanced diet. Next one is deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases. What do you mean by deficiency? Deficiency means shortage. Due to the lack of nutrients, there is a possibility of getting different kinds of diseases. And I hope you may know the meaning of diet. What do you mean by diet? The daily food we take. The daily food we take is called our diet. In that diet, if any nutrients are less, what will happen? It may cause deficiency diseases. Next term we are going to discuss is obesity. What do you mean by obesity? Obesity means whenever we take more fat rich food, what will happen? There is a possibility of increasing our fat. That means our weight will increase. Sometimes you can observe that the people is having very big tummy. So this is happening due to the overeating of fat rich food items. And next, this is also one disorder which is happening due to the intake of more food items, especially which is rich in fat. Next, we can discuss about the deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases, the first one I'm going to say is due to the deficiency of vitamin A. Due to the deficiency of vitamin A, what will happen? There is a chance for the loss of vision. Loss of vision, that is also called as night blindness. Night blindness, that the during night time the person may not be able to see the things in a proper order. That is causing due to the deficiency of vitamin A. Next, due to the deficiency of vitamin B, B or B1, it causes beriberi. And next is, what due to the deficiency of vitamin D, rickets. And it affects our bones mainly. And due to the deficiency of C, scurvy. And due to the deficiency of iron, the person will become anemia. Iron and calcium causes anemia or anemic. Calcium causes bone and tooth decay, and iodine, due to the deficiency of iodine, goiter occurs. Goiter means the glands in the neck appears swollen. So once again we can go through the deficiency diseases. First one is vitamin A. Due to the deficiency of vitamin A, loss of vision may happen. That is also called as night blindness. And the next one is vitamin B1. It causes beriberi. It makes our muscles weak. And next one is vitamin D. Rickets, the bones become soft. And the next one is C, vitamin C. It causes scurvy. Scurvy causes bleeding of gums. Iron deficiency causes anemia, we can say. Anemia, the person will look like a pain. And calcium causes bone and tooth decay. Iodine, the deficiency of iodine causes goiter, glands in the neck appears swollen. Okay, once again, I hope everyone understood. Have a good day.